big concert for a long time. My wife, Mildred Taylor, was a close friend of James, and I represent Mary Dunn, my sister-in-law. She suffered with cancer right now, so she couldn't come. She took a treatment yesterday.
Jim told me that.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. I want to welcome each and every one of you here today. And I want to, on behalf of Mr. Jim, which we would like to say good morning, Mr. Jim, and our love and concerns for you is ever near, but your friends are here. And we thank you so much for coming to respect, out of respect for Mr. Jim and Miss Jean. Miss Betty and Miss Marcia, thank you for coming to represent Mr. Jim today. This morning, as we take this time to remember the life of Jean Thomas Grammer Mytton, it's a time to remember what she was about. And it was a time to remember a gracious lady, a loving lady. We remember the words of Jesus. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they may die, yet shall they live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. I died, and behold, I am alive forevermore, and I hold the keys of hell and death. Because I live, you shall live also. Let us pray. Father, this morning we come to this place, this holy ground, as we stand at the casket of your daughter. Father, it's the place that this earthen vessel lives and rests. But Father, we know, as the scriptures have told us, that just as you live, we who believe also live. Father, we just ask you today to be with Mr. Jim there in Colorado, and be with the rest of his family who are unable to attend today. But be with those who are here today, that we can find comfort and peace in your words and bring joy to our thoughts as we think about the life of Miss Jean. Now, Father, go with us through this service, and we will give you the honor and the glory for all these things. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
There is come.
what a day it would be. What a day it was for Miss Jeanne on August the 9th, 2020, when she went home to be with Jesus. Jeanne Thomas Mytton passed away August the 9th, 2020 in Broomfield, Colorado at the Highland Trail Retirement Home. Jeanne was born on October the 30th, 1935 in Searcy, Arkansas, where she graduated from Searcy High School in 1953, continued her education at Texas Women's University in Denton, Texas, and completed her studies there in 1957. Jeanne, from an early childhood, had an everlasting love for classical music, especially opera. Now, the music that we are using today were selections that she chose and wanted at her service. And so Mr. Jim and Miss Betty have done that for her. So she was associated with the Metropolitan Opera in New York City for many years as a secretary for Francis Robinson, who was the head of the press department. Jeanne was involved with the rehearsals, the evening performances, and developed friendships with the cast members. And the one most notable was Renaldi Tebaldi, who was the leading soprano from Italy. And she revered Miss Tebaldi throughout the rest of her life. Jeanne left the Met in 1969 to join the United States Information Service in Bogota, Colombia. And she served as the secretary to the Charge of Affairs there. And while she was there, she met Mr. James Mytton, who was an assignment with the United States Geological Survey Department as a technical advisor for the Colombian government. Jim and Jeanne were married on December the 28th, 1969, back home in Searcy, Arkansas. Jim was assigned as a technical advisor to the Brazilian government at Belo Horizonte, Brazil. And their son, James G. Mytton, Jimmy, was born while they were in Brazil in 1971. They returned to the United States later that year and have resided in the Denver, Colorado area ever since then. Jeanne and Jim became active members of the Association of Retarded Citizens, known as ARC, there in Denver, Colorado. Jeanne was involved with the Mothers Mutual, as well as caring for Jimmy, their son, who was had Down syndrome. She was always available to help others and her family. Her loving devotion and care for their housekeeper, Tanya, in Brazil, and to those who became part of their lives as caregivers for Jimmy and her loving extended family are examples of her goodness. Jeanne was preceded in death by her son, James G. Jimmy Mytton, at the age of 48. And that was a long life for one with the diagnosis of Down syndrome. She was also preceded in death by her father, Grafton Thomas, and her mother, Evelyn Grammer Thomas, her aunt, Clarice Grammer, and other aunts and uncles and cousins. She is survived today by her husband, James W. Mytton, her husband of over 50 years, and many extended family members and friends. The Agape Hospice who cared for Jeanne in her last days will always be appreciated. Concluding this service, Jeanne will be laid to rest in their family plot just right up the hill from here. memorials may be made to the Art Association in Aurora, Colorado, and that address is on the folders if you would like. Corinthians, I believe it's in your memorial folder, beginning with the 16th verse. Therefore, we do not lose heart. Though outwardly we are wasting away, yet inwardly we are being renewed day by day. For our light and momentary troubles are achieving for us an eternal glory that far outweighs them all. So we fix our eyes not on what is seen, but what is unseen. For what is seen is temporary, but what is unseen is eternal. Today, as we pause for just a moment to think about the life of Miss Jeanne, there was something I always found neat as I was visiting with Betty and Marcia yesterday and seeing her life over the past few months, because we come to know Miss Jeanne last October when her and Mr. Jim made that long trip from Denver, the Denver area, to come and bring their son to where she knew as home. She traveled, listen to her life, her obituary is amazing. A young lady from Searcy, Arkansas in the early part of 1953, when she graduated, was a small town. And she went to New York, not just to New York City. And she accomplished much in her life. To my knowledge, of course, I wasn't even here in 1953, but anytime I came to Arkansas from Kansas City, they didn't have anything like the Met or anything like that, even as much in Little Rock. I mean, they had somewhat, but not to that scale. But she strove to do the very best that she could, and she accomplished that in her life. She later, she left the Met and went on to work not in this country, but in Colombia. And we're going, okay, now how does a little girl from Searcy, Arkansas accomplish that? Because she had faith that she could do that. But when her and Jim got married, they didn't do it in Brazil or in Colombia. They came home. She always came home. She knew where she could be safe, and that was here in Searcy, Arkansas. She knew where she could find peace, and that was here in Arkansas. Folks, she never left home. Her heart, you know, there's a song that says, "My heart is left in Texas," or something like that. Her heart was left in Arkansas because she wanted to come home. And arrangements were made for that. But there's one thing that we look at. Her real home, she knew about it. She had been taught about her real home. A home that she never saw here, that we'll never see here. But she had faith. When her and Mr. Jim had Jimmy and realized that something was not right and that they could not get the care for him that they needed in Brazil, they came home where they knew they could. And I believe with all my heart that a mother who has a child that has difficulties is going to do what she needs to do to care for that child, because that child is a gift, and she loved Jimmy with all she had. She cared for Jimmy, and I'm sure, not knowing the details of how involved that she was, but I'm sure that she was as involved as anyone could get in the art group out of the Denver, Colorado area. And if there was things that needed to be fixed for those kids, she was involved in it. It just seems in reading her obituary and talking to the family that she was a determined lady, but she was gracious. She did it out of love and compassion. Some of the words that I've heard about her was that she was very caring, not just for her and not for Mr. Jim, But for anyone who she knew, she cared about them. And in saying that, I believe you don't care about people if you don't love them. Maybe not like you do your close friends, but you love human beings. She was a giving person. Last October, when we were visiting with them, she said, we will be driving out there and to take care of this. And we found out their ages, and we thought, oh my, they're driving by themselves. I don't want to make that drive by myself. But they weren't afraid. They did what they needed to do to care for Jeanne. She loved the mountains. And I think I've been to Colorado and to Estes Park one time in my life. And I believe that that is some of the most beautiful little countryside that you ever want to go to. But she was just a commoner. She loved chocolate. And I believe that that's how you can see Miss Jeanne as somebody who made something of herself. And I'm sure in her lifetime, there have been rough patches. We all have those. We all have those. But you know, we have to have faith in knowing that God is in control. We have to have faith that He is going to carry us through. And Mr. Jim, to you today, I know that your companion of over 50 years is no longer with you. But she will never leave you, like she'll never leave any of us in this room that has met her. There will always be a piece of her inside of us. And as long as we remember that, we can keep her alive in our thoughts. And we can remember when we think of Searcy. Miss Betty is reminded me yesterday, she traveled to Rosebud, and we found out we knew people at Rosebud that each other knew. And one gentleman's not here, but yes, he is. We remember that. Miss Jeanne is physically not here, but yes, she is. Because you remember what she was to you. You remember stories she told you. You remember the life she lived and what she accomplished. We can accomplish much, just as she proved herself, if we just turn our lives over to Jesus and follow His lead, because He promises us that He will never leave us nor forsake us. He will not leave us orphaned, He says, for we have no hope, because we have hope, and that hope is in Jesus. So today, I want us to remember not the Miss Jeanne here, I want us to remember the pictures that we see in her life of her in New York City, this little bitty lady from Searcy, Arkansas, being in that big city by herself. But she made many, many friends, not just from the United States, but from Italy. Somebody from Searcy, that is great. Not that just Damon Searcy's not great, but it's what you want and what God gives you. And I believe those were a gift from God. I want to share real briefly, because I believe her purpose in life after she was given Jeanne was Jeanne, to take care of Jeanne. Helen Steiner Rice writes this beautiful poem, "A mother's love is something that no one can explain. It is made of deep devotion and of sacrifice and pain. It is endless and unselfish and enduring come what may, for nothing can destroy it or take it away." The last few months, Miss Jeanne's heart was empty, because of her Jeanne had gone home. But on August the 9th, she got to meet Jimmy for the first time, well and whole. And what a day that was. Mr. Jim, one of these days will be your time. But when God's ready, he will come and get you. So you can be reunited with Miss Jean and with Jimmy. And what a reunion day that will be. Let's pray. Father, today, we thank you for giving us this time to be still and remember the life of Miss Jean. Father, we continue to lift up Mr. Jim to you today. How his heart is breaking at the loss of Jimmy and Miss Jean. But Father, we know that you still have a purpose for him. The lives that he touches, our lives that he has touched here at Brother Daniel. Father, we just ask you to continue to keep him safe and wrap him in your loving arms each day. Father, grant him the peace that passes all understanding. And Father, we just ask you to do that for each one that has joined us today here. Father, be with them as they remember Jean. Father, now we thank you for this opportunity. And we give you the praise and the glory for all these things. Amen. Now, I think she had one more selection, and we're going to do it for you. And you have the words in your memorial folder if you would like to sing with us. We'll let you do that.
We see Jesus. we're going to go ahead and do the committal service here, so we won't have to be up in the wet up there. We've gone as far as we can go with this earthen vessel. What a pretty lady she was, and she is. But she ain't pretty because God created her to be what she was and what she is. But I promise you today, when she saw Jimmy and when she saw Jesus Christ face to face, she became new, became whole. And today I want us, as we stand beside this casket, I want to assure you that one of these days he's coming back, and when he does, the trumpet will sound, and the dead in Christ shall rise, and those of us who remain will join them in the air to meet Jesus face to face. So as we spend this time, Almighty God, into your hands we commend your daughter, Jeanne Thomas Mytton. Ensure and certain hope of resurrection to eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. This body we commit to the ground, as it says, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. This we commit to the ground. Now to one who was able to keep you from falling and make you stand without blemish in the presence of God's glory with rejoicing, to the only God, our Savior, through Jesus Christ our Lord, be glory, majesty, power, and authority before all times, now and forever. Amen. Amen. Miss Betty, thank you so much. Miss Marcia, thank you for being Miss Betty Rock during these days. And for you that have come, thank you for spending this time with Miss Jeanne and Mr. Jim. We were able to video it so that he can see, and we will send it to him. Just remember him in your prayers in the days to come. And say that on behalf of the Roller Daniel family and the entire Roller family, it has been our honor and our pleasure, Mr. Jim, to work with you, even though from a distance. But Miss Betty represented you well, and it has been our pleasure. And that concludes our service here. Thank you. You are so welcome.
Sure will. Sure will, Jim. You take care.
This is your second cousin, Lisa, and I'm here representing my dad, Alan, and his wife, Patsy, and our family, just to make sure that Jeanne knew that all of her family loved her very much and will miss her, but we're so glad that we could be here. And all our thoughts and prayers go out to you during this time.
Jeanne, drove all the way to Texas to my